All right, so this kind of looks like Evolving Wilds, but it's not. If I had some Cyclers or a Mountain, obviously, then this hand becomes quite good. But given the fact that I just can't really cast anything, I'm on the draw, my hand's really slow. I think I just need to mulligan this. This hand's similar, but a little better, because at least I have a play. But not exactly stellar. Alright, that gives my hand a little something to do. Go away, Skype. Gonna cheat of them. This seems like a good game to cycle to get Scaled Monitor online. Like, I get the card back, but I ramp quickly to a 6-7. That seems worth it. My guess is they won't exert here just because there's no reason to. Which means the cheat is having Flash here is actually kind of nice, because if I just played a 3-2, I wouldn't get to trade. For the next big thing. Yeah, got a 4-3. One nice thing is we have lands in our deck. We have a land in our deck that cycles, so that's a pretty good cycler to actually cycle here. I don't really want to cycle actual cards anytime soon. Obviously, besides this one. I think that card's really good. Let's get another forest. No! Why Magic Online? Why do you hate me? I think hiding the Grasping Dunes is some pretty good value. My opponent might make weird, like different blocks, not knowing that I have -1/-1 coming after. If this just attacks, I guess they need to cycle 3 cards to get me. 2 is just a trade, so that's not horrible. So I'd probably block. Otherwise, what am I doing with my Behemoth? Having Hexproof and just slamming down the threat's pretty nice. Because this would be the type of spot where, like, I play a giant creature, my opponent plays Final Reward, and the game ends. And that's just not going to happen right now. So I'm pretty happy about that. Would I rather have a 3-4 or a 5-6? I kind of think the 6-7 is better. Just have a 2-3 as well. I have the option also just not playing my creature and then waiting and putting it on something else. Because a 2-3 is just so bad versus the 4-3. It's not an awful line. Like, if I happen to draw a Naga Vitalist or just some throwaway creature, then that works. The problem with that is I don't have that many throwaway creatures in my deck. Well, I didn't need those anyways. Probably lucky that they didn't actually cycle this. Good thing I played my desert, my dunes. We played around on Burden. Haha! It's a creature, so could be worse. It's also a pretty good one. I mean, I can just start attacking with that. Three damage every other turn. So cards we're looking for right now are like Heaven to Earth and seven sevens. I guess removal spell is fine too. Well, now the Bitter Blade doesn't attack as well. Also, Destined Elite is pretty absurd on the Behemoth. We can cast it in the same turn and deal 7 damage. We get to kill multiple creatures, so. Actually, I would just put it on this, huh? Destined Elite on this. Kill their whole board, because it has Death Touch. I kind of don't think I need to use the final ward. I'm just not going to attack. Because before I could do this, and then I'd end up with an 0-1. So the trade's not really that good. So let's just keep waiting until they have something I need to actually deal with. I think this game is just about being patient. And winning some combat way later on. Also, drawing this card and holding it really doesn't look any different than me just drawing a land. Because I would hold the land in this spot too. So pretty much just gonna Drago until something changes here. I feel favored in the long game unless they have something I'm not expecting. Like Destined Elite is just gonna win. They could have that card too, to be fair, but I can stop it reasonably well. Like I could try to make aggressive attacks, but it just opens up. just opens me up to losing an otherwise favorable slow game, I think. We have 8 mana right now. I'm kind of wondering if I want to play a land or not. I think I don't, just because if there is another Unburden, my opponent could just cast it. The only reason I would want to is to be able to play two big spells in a turn. I definitely will play the next land I draw, though. That card's pretty good. I don't think I want a final reward though, because Behemoth just already blocks. If they use a trick, like if they use the +2/+0 bring it back trick, I get a 2-for-1 if I just wait. Giving this trample is a pretty big game. Maybe just kill this guy. If they cycle two spells in response, I just won't have a fight. That'd be pretty hard to do, though. Plus two until end of turn. Are they gonna cycle something? Well, we traded one for one. I traded Shed Weakness for a Cartouche. Let's choose no. I think I will play my land just so I can have Magma's Prey up too. So my opponent right now could lead on that, but then I could final reward and make really profitable blocks everywhere. Do this pre-blocks. Seven, 12, 13, 14. So I don't have lethal on the crackback. I think this is a pretty clear block. These can just bounce, which is fine. Costs four to bring back next turn. This is only bad if they have dissenters trick. I could also just Magma Spray this so it doesn't come back. In which case, trading this is fine. So they'll probably cast Shed Weakness first, so I'm not going to get blown out if they have that card. So I think it's worth just casting this. Now attack with everything. And play another creature. So they really need to stabilize the board here. I've got a 7/8 hexproof trample. Beetle is a good start. Probably on Colossipede. Oh, whoops. I was thinking it got to put a counter on my creature when it came in. No, it's only a second ability. Okay. Well, that makes sense putting it there. Well, that probably changes things too. If they weren't dead, they're probably dead now. So I have 7, 8, 9, 13, 18 trample, and they have 3, 4, 5, 10. So I'm going to trample for 8, unless they have a trick. I could Grasping Dunes first. I don't think that's worth it, though, depending how they block. I imagine they're just dead to the Cherry Deer. Grindy game one, but we got there. So, I don't imagine every game's gonna go like that. Magma Spray was okay, but not great. Stinging Shot would have been horrible that whole game. I think Synchronized Strike actually is pretty good if boards get wide, because you can win two different combats. I'm afraid they did have the 3-2s, though. And it randomly can hose other cards. If they get the Scorpion small enough, I can also just exile the Scorpion, which is good. If the games are super grindy every time, Pursue Glory is nice. But really, I just have a bunch of 7 drops and Destined to Lead. So I feel reasonably favored in a long game. So if it goes the same way, I'm kind of okay with that. Heaven to Earth is great. I can kind of control how I'm doing that. Fling is a reasonable option. Is Ornery Kudu good? Okay, not great. If they randomly have like a flyer, this is still fine. So yeah, I think I'm just not going to board much. Not that there's a ton of different ways to board. I wonder if they'll choose to draw. I mean, the game was grindy. Okay, they choose to play. I have the Sandworm to cycle, and then Kudu into Spider, so I think I still keep this. I'll note also that Unburdened is better on the draw. But maybe my opponent agrees that they're unfavored in a long game. So then just getting to play has a pretty big advantage. It's kind of risky to cycle a 7 drop in this matchup, but I think cycling the first one is fine, given I'm not doing anything else. More important to hit land drops right now. This card seems a little better than playing a 2-3. Just get the giant spider down and then go from there. Only have to take 2 to do so. And if I draw a swamp, I just have Final Reward mana all of a sudden. Little mirror match here. Mirror match never hurt anyone. Ooh, Scorpion is good. No, settle in for the long one. Destined to lead on Wasteland Scorpion is kind of just the game. I guess I could tap my Vitalist. So I actually probably should just attack if that's the case. Because that card just blows me out so much. Alright, so now I can play this without fear, which is nice. That is a giant blowout. I regret everything. Oh boy. I mean, I could just cycle the sandworm, but I kind of feel like it's my path to victory. Not that the Vitals was really helping me cast any spells here. That one's good. I should just do that now so I could potentially draw a land. Swamp seems way more important than mountain right now. Also, I'm kind of getting color screwed because of this desert, so I guess I somewhat deserve that. All right. Now we're talking. So what if I double block Giant Spider here? If they have synchronized strike, they deal me 6 damage and I lose a creature. Actually, double block doesn't really play around plus two though. I could double block the Quarry Hauler. That one does play around plus two. It loses to Final Reward though. I also just have Destined to lead, right? So yeah, no, I should just double block the Giant Spider because I have the re-trick. I forgot I just have this up, so it's actually pretty easy block. So if they have this card, I'd blow them out. If they have the plus two trick, I'd blow them out. And if they have nothing, I just need a giant spider for 4 damage. This is actually pretty good for them. We won for one, but it's not a true like blowout here because they don't actually lose their creature. Like as tricks go there, that one worked out decently well for them. What if I just put a counter on this and then attack with both and try to get the synchronized strike blowout? It's like early up in the format that that might work, and if they don't do that, then I just Evolving Wilds and that's fine too. I think it's worth going for. Basically, the downside of that play is not getting to play my 3-3, which is not a huge deal. Like, if my opponent just doesn't attack me. If they attack me with just Giant Spider, I'm still just, I think, gonna bite. Because I get a card out of it. And holding back is particularly bad versus lead in my graveyard anyways. They probably just want to race. So this play is, I think, more likely to work. Just block like this so that if they +2/+ here, at least it's a trade. Prevent all combat damage. That is kind of a blowout. They must have just drawn that card, because otherwise you would cycle it years ago. Double red seems better than quadruple green when I have Heaven to Earth in my deck. Now let's deck with a 3-4 and play the Sandworm, I think. Actually, maybe attack with a 2-4. 3-4 is good if Sandworm dies. Could attack with both and put them to 10. If they kill my Sandworm and deal me 7, how bad is that? Kind of bad. I'm not just dead to death. No, I am dead to destined to lead if I do that, though. They destine one of these and then lead for lethal. So again, I think I'm just going to win the long game. So I'm just going to attack for 2 here. And just play conservatively. Well, do I lose to destine to lead? I just have final reward. No, I guess I just don't. Like I won't play my I won't play my 3-3 if that's the case. I'm just trying to think of sequences that can have us lose since we're way ahead. I don't think going all in on lead here is a good idea. I think just probably play Charioteer for trample and attack for 7. I'm gonna get a nice little blowout here. They double block. I get rid of that one. Trample for 4. Game just ends. Alright, on to the finals. Yeah.